Have you ever wondered why we decorate the Christmas tree? And why we light the Yule log? Why we hang the mistletoe? And why we teach our children to believe in Santa Claus? Over the course of this video, you may be surprised or even shocked to discover the true origins behind these traditions. Chances are, you will never look at Christmas the same again.
Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world.
The word Christmas comes from Christus Mass, an early English phrase that means Mass of Christ. The supreme act of worship consists essentially in an offering of a worthy victim to God, the offering made by a proper person as a priest for the destruction of the victim. Mary means happy, Christ is equivalent to Jesus, and Mass means death or destruction. You add those together, you get happy Jesus, death or destruction. A wreath is a known funeral arrangement, so there's no coincidence that around Christmas time, they're hung on their doorposts commemorate the death of Christ.
And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
It is very clear from Scripture that Jesus was not born in the winter. The shepherds who saw the angels announcing his birth would not have been out in their fields in December. The Palestinian winters were too cold for that. The date of December 25th comes from Rome and was a celebration of the Italian god Saturn and the rebirth of the sun. This was done long before the birth of Jesus. In Germany, the evergreen tree was used in worship and celebration of the Yule god, also in observance of the resurrected sun god. Many of the Christmas traditions derive from the pagan Rome festival called Saturnalia, which has evolved to the pagan festival Yule. This is an illustration of a pagan or witch wheel. Notice the celebration of Yule. And here are excerpts from an actual witch website. Notice the deities and the symbolism of Yule. Also notice the symbols of Yule. The Yule log, or small Yule log with three candles, evergreen bowls or wreaths, holly, mistletoe hung in doorways. Also notice the foods of Yule. You have cookies, fruits, nuts, pork dishes, turkey, eggnog. Now I want you to take a look at the activities of Yule. You have caroling, wassailing the trees, burning the Yule log, decorating the Yule tree, exchanging of presents, kissing under the mistletoe, honoring Kris Kringle, the Germanic pagan god of Yule. Now look at the spell workings of Yule. Peace, harmony, and love, and increase happiness. These all equal to the satanic worship that you call Christmas.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And that's what Christmas is all about.
You hear that, boy? That's what Christmas is all about.
Actually, Granddad, Christmas is a pagan holiday. And Jesus probably hates you for celebrating it.
There ain't gonna be no Scrooges in this house, boy.
Look, Grandad, it's clear from the scripture that Jesus was not born in winter. The shepherds who saw the angels announcing his birth would not have been out in their fields in December. The Palestinian winters are too cold, if you believe in that sort of thing. The truth is, Christmas evolved from the Roman holiday Saturnalia, a winter festival where men gave gifts to each other. They also would get drunk, have sex with each other, and beat their wives. People would act so crazy on Christmas, the holiday was outlawed by the Protestant Church until the 1800s. As a matter of fact, the United States Congress... Granddad?
I'm sorry, boy. What was that?
I just explained the entire history of Christmas.
But it was boring, Huey. You just blah, blah, gay sex, blah, blah, Congress. You know, you gotta be interesting.
These pagan satanic customs were around before Christ was even born. And we know that by looking into the Bible in Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 2, it reads, "Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them." So what are the signs of heaven? If we go into Genesis chapter 1, verse 14, it reads, "And God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs, and for seasons, and for days, and years." Verse 15, "And let them be for lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth, and it was so." Verse 16, "And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also." So the signs of heaven that God was talking about in Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 2, were the sun and the moon and the stars and all the hosts of heaven. Those were meant to be for signs and for seasons and for days. So the people in Jeremiah were already worshiping the sun in those days. Now let's take a look at what else they were doing at that time.
"For the customs of the people are vain. For one cutteth a tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workmen with the axe. They deck it with silver and with gold. They fasten it with nails and with hammers, that it move not. They are upright as the palm tree, but speak not. They must needs be born, because they cannot go. Be not afraid of them, for they cannot do evil. Neither also is it in them to do good."
So now we can see that way back before Christ was even born, they were already worshiping the sun and hanging Christmas trees in their homes. These customs came way before Christ. It's nothing more than the same pagan satanic rituals that were done well before Christ. It is my sincere prayer that after watching this video, that you will flee from this satanic and pagan holiday and turn and follow the true Christ. God knows my heart.
The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it?
I'm not worshiping the sun or any of those things. I'm doing this to worship Christ.
Howbeit in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
S-A-N-T-A, S-A-T-A.